Welcome back to the channel. So today we are going to be sewing this dress, and to do that I need my basic bodice block and then my basic skirt block. So I'm using a full front pattern for both front and back, and please ignore that line. I've actually used the pattern before. So to start with, I'm going to take my front pattern and work on it. So the side, I'm going to mark 0.5 inches and then I'm going to mark 4 inches going up, and then I'll mark my neck depth. So this neck depth I marked here, I still went ahead to change it later on, so I'll just use this as a reference. So I marked 10 inches as my neck depth. I'm going to close my that, and then I'm going to work on my armor part. So at my armor side, I went up by 4 inches and then I rose straight, and from that line I came in 0.5 inches and then connected to the 0.5 inches at the side. So I actually went ahead and do a little bit of test running by making that side 1 inch, but at the end of the day I just felt that 0.5 inches is enough for what I want to achieve there. So on that line I'm going to go up by 1 inch and then create 0.5 inches line and join it to my neckline. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is to mark my bust circumference, and to do that I need the measurement from my bust point to my under bust. Mine is 3.5 inches, so reduce it by 0.5 inches and then I'll mark the circle by that 3 inches that remain. So at the side I'm going to measure 1.5 inches, so if you're on the bigger bust size you can use 2 inches. So I'm just going to rule it like that and then connect it to my circle and then join it to the center front. So I noticed that I want my neck depth to be deeper, so I went in and just mark it. So the total length of the neck depth I use is 11 inches. So at this point, I'm just going to use another marker to mark out my point and cut it out. So at my dart side, I'm going to measure 0.5 inches to the left and to the right, and then I'll join it to my down part and connect it to my bust point area, and then I'll cut out my pattern. So I'm going to be using that area for the ruching. So what I did here is to add another pattern paper and then cover it up and cut it out. So I'm going to be working on my back side at this point. So what I'm going to do is to measure the same fold I measure at the armhole really straight, take 0.5 inches left and right my that, and then I'm going to go ahead and cut it out. So now I'm going to work on my down parts. The first thing I did from my waist is to measure the length, which is 20 inches. And then from my other side, the side I want the cuff to start from my hip, I just measure 5 inches down. And then I connect it to the side and then I cut it out. So since I'm going to be using this pattern for the back skirt, so what I would do there is to go ahead and add a little bit of extra at that center point, like that center front line, just to make sure that when I'm joining it together, like when I'm sewing it together, the two of them matches up with each other, and then I can trim off any excesses. So when I'm done doing that mark, when I'm okay with the mark I made, I'll just go ahead and cut the down part, and then I'll close my that, and then I'm ready to cut. So after cutting my fabric and then the lining, I went ahead and sewed my front part. So the first thing I did is to put interfacing on one of my piece at the upper part. So when I'm done doing that, I went ahead and cut this using my front part, using that line, the measurements from that line. So I'm just going to go ahead and start from the back. I went ahead and joined it together, and then I trim it off, and then I'll place the front part on it and sew. And when I'm done, I'm just going to go ahead and ruched the area of that dart, and then I'll sew it on this down part. So it might be a little bit tricky when you're trying to sew on that sharp edge. So what you should do is just mark like 0.5 inches down and then cut it, so like notch it, so when you're turning it became very easy. So that's what I did. So I use 15 inches for my strap here. Later on, I realized that my strap is a little bit too long. So you're going to use like 13.5 inches or 14 inches. I think that will be good. So when I'm done, I'm just going to set this aside and I will go ahead and join it to my down part. So please share, like and subscribe, and please turn off the notification bell so that the next time I upload a new video, you'll be the first to be notified. Thank you. So after I'm done sewing, I'm just going to go ahead and top stitch this outside after ironing, and then my dress is done. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.